this is the concept of the kind of tape boxes, and this tape will use it. This though is a whenever basically first designed by Alan Turing, but still today for any computer science machine, we use this kind of tape. Okay, we can really realize this kind of tape to our RAM. Is a series of RAM in our machine. Say if you have 8 GB RAM, you can think of this kind of a tape. So basically computation is done serially, later on parallelly, and all these things will come. But the basic fundamental computer, whatever design, another thing I must tell, that this tape, the first portion in with the concept we have come yesterday, the Turing machine, then the another concept come, the universal Turing machine. That is the more powerful concept, and that concept I have already told last class. What is universal Turing machine? Universal Turing machine input string consists of a front portion from the left, the front portion, and then that is called the program portion, and another is the data portion. When the front portion is read by a Turing machine, a general Turing machine, then the Turing machine basic control unit configuration change. It become a more knowledgeable sort of thing. And then the data portion begins, and then this knowledgeable portion will act on it, and whatever the result, read it and put it on the same tape. So that is basically concept of computer till today. You think of this is the your memory, your primary memory, 8 GB RAM here, and you forget about the operating system part and all these things. Say your program part, your program, whatever program you are writing in C, it basically convert to say A dot out, that is the executable file, runs on your Linux machine or Windows machine, maybe exe file. That is basically it is not changeable portion. That program is should not be changeable. The Turing machine just read this, and then this control of the Turing machine, control of the Turing machine becomes more knowledgeable, and then the data portion comes, it acts on the data, and whatever the output, it is writing on it. That is called the concept of universal Turing machine. That is a very powerful concept, and that I also told you last day. This whole idea has been designed by Alan Turing, a very theoretical design he has done. At that time, no Mealy machine, Moore machine, or pushdown automata, nothing is developed. But concept was finite state machine is there, because all the computer before 1930s are all basically nothing but finite state machine computer, like our slide rule and abacus and all this. So, but when the how to put the programmability part and all these things have done by single-handedly by Alan Turing, he's a game changer basically. He's almost regarded as Albert Einstein of computer science. So this is it. What are the machines that are different than other than finite state machine we have used in our regular expression detection or pushdown automata? Here, machine have two kinds of state. One is accepting state, another is rejecting state. The rejecting state concept is not there. So with this one, we are always want to see where we are. Non-deterministic pushdown, and in fact, we are not use this because it is non-deterministic pushdown is very difficult to realize. Very difficult. This diagram is very interesting. You can remember this kind of grammar. This is a typical a to the power n, b to the power n, c to the power n grammar. And see here, the rule changes. The left hand side, see, this is context sensitive grammar. Why it is called context sensitive? Because you have a variable and there is another context to it. So, because we have a double one or more, so CB goes to BC and AB, AB, BB, BB, and this will generate, if you use it, you can iterate, then you can create ABC, A square, B square, C square, A cube, B cube, C cube, all these things. This cannot be done by only a Turing machine, linear bounded Turing machine, and it is a parsing is very difficult. Parsing concept comes, I told you, for regular expression, we don't have the parsing concept because it is always very easy. For pushdown machine, pushdown automata, context switch grammar, we not only we want to know whether it is accept or reject, but we also know how it is come from your start symbol S. So that is the thing of role of a parsing. The parsing is the main thing, because in a natural language processing, right now whatever we doing the formal language. The formal language, one extension of formal language is our programming languages, like our C, Python, Java, whatever you are using. In your next computer career. So that is a basic formal language is a basic fundamental block. And then comes the artificial intelligence, machine learning, which area, interesting area. That there you, it is called the natural language processing. Natural language processing, how the robot talks with you in the natural language. There are various kinds of robot bot services which they very naturally talk with, that they should have a natural language processing. So there we can have, there may be grammar, it may not be deterministic context grammar, we can have some context sensitive grammar also, then maybe certain instruction. So that instruction may took a little bit of time, we don't mind, because whenever you are talking to a person or anyone, you don't expect that the person immediately reply back. It is basically a rudeness. So if the computer thinks a little, maybe 10 seconds, it doesn't worry you. That is more natural whenever you are human and thinking. So that is the reason might be. It's a more powerful grammar you can there. And there the complexity is the NP complete thing. It is definitely more not polynomial problem like n square, n log n. Problem like any sorting algorithm, or it is not your 2 to the power n problem, it is more complex. It's a more complex thing. This is Turing machine. Let's go to the we have basically got into the Michael Sixer's book in the chapter. I think this is a chapter 3. More or less, my Turing machine and PDA, I'll cover it from this book. And I will okay. So, this is the control unit that is a finite state machine, and it's a tape alphabet. Here the tape alphabet, they take this symbol is a part of a tape alphabet, which is sigma. Our sigma is the alpha input alphabet, and tape alphabet means sigma plus this one. This means it's a tape alphabet. Can both write on the tape and read from it. That I have told you, read, right head can move both left and right. Remember, our head cannot move stationary. So any configuration states, like whenever you go for a delta transition functions, tape cannot say I cannot move. Tape has to move either left or right. Tape may read, they have to read, they may write or may not write, okay, but it has to go left and right, okay. This is the main basic concept of Turing machine. To cover that, this is might be little bit confusing to you. This is very interesting diagram which Turing machine can only solve. This is WW grammar, W hash W grammar. Hash denotes it is a bit point, and this is the W, and the same W is repeated here. And I have told you that you cannot do it through the pushdown automata, because pushdown automata, if you push all this 0, 1, 1, 000 into a stack, and whenever you, when the this zero comes, and whenever this comes, then you know this is a W hash W grammar. So this must be matched with this zero, not this zero. But where is this zero? This is at the bottom of the stack. How to get it? So this is not possible. So this is the main failure point of the deterministic pushdown machine. So here, how to solve the problem in the Turing machine? Turing machine, what they do? They first they search for whether there is any hash sign or not. If it doesn't see any, this is I am saying the algorithm steps of a Turing machine. If first they search for a hash or not. If the hash is not there, then it go to the reject state. So it don't. And remember, Turing machine, unlike your finite state machine or PDA, it can go only this direction once. No, it can always back and forth. So you might think this Turing machine takes more amount of time, but it goes to his decision very quickly. But whenever I have already told that a to the power n, b to the power n grammar, though Turing machine can solve it with his own algorithm, but that might be slower. So in that kind of problem, parenthesis problem, we always use deterministic pushdown automata. But where, like W hash W grammar, where your PDA cannot do, then Turing machine must come. That is, though it takes little more amount of time, because back and forth is there. But remember, in computer hardware, whatever you read it, computer hardware, I think you must computer organization, back and forth doesn't need take much amount of time. Basically, you are shifting the pointer. Actually, time requires in the writing operation. So any computer, basic computer operations, even reading is much faster. Writing takes time, because whenever you want to write something on your memory, you want to again recheck it whether you write correctly or not. So if say information sake, if the reading takes the 10 nanosecond, writing may need 20 or 30 nanosecond. I'm just giving and shifting maybe. So writing is more time consuming. But one thing again, your Pushan Automata doesn't write anything at all. It's basically it is a stupid machine. It just says whether I accept or reject. Nothing else. Even it writes some other programs writes it in the parse tree. Okay, that takes time, because ultimately the parse tree has to be written in the binary tree. Binary tree, data structure algorithm. You know how to store a binary tree with the pointer and concept in a separate memory area, or maybe you have known that it has to be stored in a table, symbol table, where you keep your ID and all these things. Okay, so writing is there, but Turing machine writing built into the machine itself, so writing is takes little time. So coming back to this, so first it search for whether this is not there, then it is go to the reject state, and you remember the reject state is a totally different concept nowhere in finite state machine or in Pushdown automata. And once the machine jumps to a reject state, it cannot come out. Okay, that is one thing. One machine goes to a accept state, it doesn't come out. Okay, but if you see here in FSM, that even go to the accept state, again go jump again to accept, again go to reject state. So in Turing machine, not there. It is a one kind of finite state machine. There are states accepting state, and there are states called rejecting states. One, the rejecting state, the computer, whether your machine jumps to a reject state due to some configuration, I will say configuration, what the configuration I will come to later, then it cannot go to again back accepting states, vice versa. So first it, whenever they first encounter one first zero, first is okay, this character is there, then it is a cross, and it will go up to this and whether it is zero or not. If it is found one, say it will go to the reject state altogether. Okay, it doesn't have to do all other checkings. So that is Turing machine is much smarter. It's very smarter. If it's found zero, it cross again. Then again it go back here and it make cross, and again it go back here, it make it cross. So these all the subsequent steps, it must check that there will be all access here and hash, and all access here, then it go only accept. Nowhere before, accept is very particular state, and any deviation, it goes to the reject state. So that is it. So that is a very intelligent way of doing it. You can argue why not I can put 2x together, and whenever I'll go it here, I mark 2x together, but you see that is unreasonable. But there will be various combination, maybe 0 1 1 1 1 0. So it is better it is done by it one at a time. So Turing machine is basically very it looks stupid, but it is not at all stupid. It took only write it only one character, and either left or right, it can solve all the problem. That is the slow and steady wins the race concept. So if it jumps, it reads two characters, write two characters, doesn't solve the problem. So in your life also, you see this kind of thing happening. If you take small steps together and correctly, and rethink and redo, then you will be successful. Like this kind of thing. So basically, one life philosophy you can put in around in Turing machine that way, that it though acts very slowly and stupidly, but it moves on. Always it moves on. It reads, and then it may write or may not write, but it must move left or right. And you worry that if it goes to the left, then your string might not be in at all, but you have to go right to see the full string. But Turing machine that is very intelligent. It doesn't have to read all. If it's found any foul here, any combination here, it automatically go to the reject state in the finite state machine, and reject state, once it is gone, it cannot go back. So that is very smart. And this is the called configuration steps. This is the Q is here the state we are typically takes Q0 is the starting state, Q0, Q1 and all this, and this is one of the your input alphabet. Okay, here input alphabet 0 and 1 in the last class, and this is the tape alphabet. This is a tape alphabet. This is tape alphabet because other than 0, 1, your blank should be accommodated. So that's the tape alphabet. What is the difference between input alphabet sigma and tape alphabet? Tape alphabet consists of one or two, so more symbols like cross, space, like this. And these are the L and R, either it has to go L or R, one of it. So this is the typical configuration. So let's see, what is the Turing machine tuple. See how many tuples, 1, 2, 3, 4, 7 tuples. This is, you can always remember these tuples. If your Mealy machine or Moore machine, you have tuples, your Turing machine also 7 tuple. What is very easy, this Q is the set of states, okay. Sigma is input alphabet not containing black symbol, blank not containing, it is a gamma tape alphabet, like here it is enclosed into this. So I also compare with the our Pushdown automata. Pushdown automata, there is also gamma is a tape alphabet, but Pushdown automata doesn't require your gamma should include your sigma, okay. Gamma totally all together, whenever you are reading A, you pushing it as a, you can as a capital A also, because this is your own domain. But here you remember this this gamma should contain sigma, because whatever tape alphabet is has to be written again by a machine, so it cannot be a different, A cannot be capital. So I give an example. In Pushdown automata you have a sigma as input alphabet and you have a gamma as a stack alphabet, and this gamma must include Z0 end of stack marker. This gamma may consist of sigma, definitely may consist all sigma, no issue. And you must add one end of stack symbol, that is Z0. Here it is blank, but here this your gamma Pushdown automata, this A you can store it as capital A also. So then your alphabets change, then you can say it is a separately old new alphabet, but here it cannot. Here A should be small, A should be small A, small 0 should be 0. So that's it. So Q0 is the start state, Q accept is the accept state, Q reject is the Q. This is very Q accept and Q reject cannot be true. That's obvious. This is very important. This is what it says. This is we have a say string, it is W, and this is also, this is a say W, and this is another V consist of. Whenever the Q7, the a Turing machine is configuration is that means your head is on here. This is the second part, and this is your first part. So head is the here. So that is the way you write a Turing machine configuration, and that is your one transition function. Say if you are in a QI state, and if you are reading B, that means your head on B, then you go to the QJ state, and you take out B, write C. Okay, it can or may not can, but these steps say I instead of B, I write C, and I go one more step right. So this is the possible a transition function. Like you are in QI, you are in your symbol, you are just reading is B, that then your dealt QI B, and after one step, you are go to the QJ state, and you write C instead of B, and you go right. It can be left also. It should not be two. It should be either L or R. Two languages is there. One is Turing recognizable. Another is Turing decidable. These are all type 0 language. Call a language Turing recognizable if some Turing machine recognizes it. You see here a small symbol 1. I'll come to this. So this is the here. 1 means it is a recursively enumerable language in some other. So Turing decidable language, I prefer Turing decidable language because as per Michael Sipser, alternative name is recursively enumerable language. This is the outer set. That means Turing machine recognize. This is more tougher language. Most easier language is recursive language, and that is called Turing decidable. Then Turing machine is always halts this case. And here in this case, Turing machine halts, but in the for the complement of this language, Turing machine may not halt. May halt or may not halt. Probably may not halt. So, but here in recursive language, it is a recursive language means it is a Turing decidable language. So, it is called recursive language or So recursive language and Turing decidable language are same thing as per Michael Sipser, and this is a type 0 language, which is just after the context sensitive. Just outer ring of the context sensitive language is a recursive language or Turing decidable language. Language generated from this grammar is always Turing machine will halt. Halt is good, and if any complement of this language is also Turing machine halt. That is, it is Turing decidable language. Turing knows it will decide. It parsing may take the NP time, NP complete problem. Okay, but it will do. And but recursively is another stage, another tougher grammar. This function, transition function, there I go to this diagram. Yeah, that is very interesting. Yesterday I covered this problem. This is the interesting function. This is the interesting 0 to the power 2 to the power n, where the input alphabet only 0 and the language is 0 or 00000 or 00 4 zeros or 8 zeros, 16 zeros, 32 zeros, 64 zeros, 120 zeros. It's a language, okay, because the zeros is coming very regular order. It's basically 0 to the power 2 to the power n. So how to get it done by PDA? PDA cannot, that you know. FSM cannot, because FSM cannot detect this thing. FSM can detect maybe up to certain, say 128, but 256, okay. But it can go to 2 to the power n is any number, then FSM will fail. FSM is okay for n is limited to it. Then we can make a design for it. PDA nowhere, okay. Here, what we have done the strategy? We have strategy, say, we left to right. If we see odd number of zeros, that means it cannot be done, because any 0 to 2 to the power 2 to the power n cannot be an odd number of zeros. So we first see if it's odd number, then you are finished. Then, but accepting 1, because 1 0, it can come from the, it is a 0 to 2 to the power 2 to the power n, 0 and 0, 1 0 can be there. Any odd number of zeros accepting 1 is not okay. Accepting 1 is okay, 1 is okay, but odd number of zeros is not okay. So if it is an even number of zeros, you cross only second zero. You cross the only second zeros. Then again count it. If it is even, then again keep on doing it. When it comes to single zero, we accept it. If any point of time it is not a single zero or odd number of zeros. So this is a very simple steps by Turing machine. So what are the thing to be done? So these are the input alphabet. This is the only input alphabet, and this is your tape alphabet, where 0 is there and you make a cross, and this is the blank sign, and you see the input alpha input states is Q accept, Q reject, and this is your transition functions. If you see, it looks a bit odd. Say if it's a Q1 and anything other than 0, it go to the reject state. Yeah, that's true. Anything, if a single 0 is there, if a single 0, then go to accept, and any more zero amount of zero, you keep crossing each other for all this, and you ultimately accept, otherwise you go to reject. So this is the way. So any more zeros, it will a single zero, it goes to accept, and any other, it will make a cross and all this thing. It can cross this way also. It's a loop. It jump to this Q accept, otherwise it goes to the Q reject. So these things, this is a restriction. What does it mean? B to be changed to C, QI to goes to QJ, and it left. So this will be your string. So this is the QI, then it goes to the QJ, C to be written. So this is it. This is for R, and this is for L, because your QI, QJ, and L. So QJ comes here, and if it is R, then this would be the thing. So your QI, your QJ comes here, is R. One is left and another is R. Turing machine, because Turing machine, I found it very interesting, I think, proven that Turing multi-head Turing machine, multi-head, that is Turing machine, lots of universal Turing machine, I have just given idea. In fact, I must tell, that is, our nature is not doing computation by this way. This is totally artificially done. Because you know the virus evolution, all they are not using this Turing machine. So Turing machine is fully artificial one. It is totally man-made. and the DNA computing is actually nature is using, and that is different from Turing machine. And also quantum computing, now nature might use it, and we are also experimenting. That's a different than Turing machine. Now Turing machine is basic fundamental block of this computer science till now.